running well. Now I'm going to start open this.
So this is, you can see, this is the column full of the a number who called this one. Okay.
Yeah, this is RTP protocol and tail this. Okay, I'm using the codec adaptive multirate IMR in this case. I think this is white.
Hello, welcome to Rifki the Cyber. Today I'm going to show it to you how we can do some the real-time call tracing for the faulty call, voice over LTE call in this case. As you already know that the faulty is running on the using the SIP, right? Using the IMS. What we're gonna do, our goal today, I will just show it to you how we do the some call tracing. We will do some faulty call, voice over LTE call, and we will display and look at it from the Wireshark, from the Majestic Packet Analyzer, the famous one, the Wireshark. So we can see, oh okay, this is the invite request, or this is the trying of ringing, etc. And we can see who is the disconnect the call, for example, from the uplink or downlink, using the buy, is the buy request is 200, okay. We can see it directly from the Wireshark. How to do that, rather than the further talk about this one, let's start now, guys. Okay guys, the first thing is, we will go to this GitHub. We will using the SCAT tool, the Signaling Collection Analysis tool. This is the contributor. And the one who really active is Sinjo Park. I want to give the credit to Sinjo, is the one who usually the more active answering in the issue. And I think this is the one, he's the one who do the commit, etc. The most active guy in developer. Of course, there are some contributors, but I think the main guy is Sinjo himself, Sinjo Park. Terenen. How you can install this? If you want to know how you install this, you just need to follow this video in the thumbnail, this one. Actually in this GitHub, there is a way how to install this one, pip install, etc. But I prefer using some isolations of the Python environment in this case. So like Python 3-m, fenv, and then what is the environment, for example, mysCAT or the SCAT environment, and then you already create those Python environment, and then you go to the directory and then typing source bin activate, etc. And before, after that, then you good to go to your, to running this pip install, guys. How to do it, I will just show you. This is the video, this is the thumbnail, or also I will give the link of the video in the description, guys. Okay, with the usage, etc. Also, I saw it also in that video, but I would like to highlight this one because SIP itself is the TCP, is the IP base. In these tools, the SCAT tools for the protocol level, the RRC, Radio Resource Control, is using the in the 4729 itself, the port in the UDP is encapsulated in this UDP for port 4729. But later, we also using this 47290. This is being told by the developer itself. Okay, if you want to see the IP transaction, you need to see this 47920. 47920 in this case, guys. Okay, now we will try how to do this, guys. Okay, so what I'm gonna do, I'm going to use Redmi Note 7 rooted, TWRT rooted, guys. Yeah, let's check, guys, how to do it. I will just plug my device here. Okay, after I plug my device, then I am going to start to running this. I will just go to CD. I will just go to desktop. Oh yeah, actually I already create my environment for SCAT is this one. Grab-es. I think this is my folder CD my SCAT. This is what I told you guys to make the isolated environment for this one. Okay, I will go to this one and then type source bin activate. Okay, now I'm good to go to running the SCAT tools. Now I already plug, I just plug my USB, I just plug my handset in this case. So what I'm gonna do, I'm going to, okay, this is the tools, I think 0 to 0. Let me unplug and plug it again. Let me check one more things. I will running LS USB. Okay, I will run in, I will plug again LS USB. Okay, that means our device is this one, number 3. Okay guys, okay, great. So how to run it, just sudo scat -t, because this is Qualcomm chipset, we are using this one. Exynos is using the SEC, SEC, etc. If you want to show how we running for Exynos, etc., you just need to look this video, guys. Okay,
I running Samsung and also OnePlus 3, etc. And also the Redmi Note 7, I running the three different phone in this video. You just look at that one, guys. I running also for the Exynos processor, that guys. And minus U, minus A, and then this is as 0 to 0, and then 003 minus EU. We're just running this. Oh, sorry. Okay, guys, I get the error access denied in this case. So this is happened to my Redmi Note 7 that already rooted, TWRT, etc. So how we can solve this one is easy, guys. So what I'm gonna do, I'm going to show you how to solve this one. Let me project my handset in this case, okay? So the first thing that you're gonna do, if you found this kind of error, you need to go to this Thermux, guys, okay? I will just click the Thermux, and then running SU. Guys, if your phone is not rooted, you will get fail in this case. You will get like SU is inaccessible or it's not exist in this case. And then I'm going to type this command, set prop. Just in case you cannot read this, there is S in this case, guys, right? Set prop sys USB config DAC ADB. So if this is there is no error, that means you good to go. We will try to run it again, okay? But don't forget to run it LS USB in this case. Okay, because it's jumping to 004. Usually it's like that. It's one time fail will be jumping, okay? Also, guys, about the interface, I also show in that video, this one, how we enable the interface. For example, if the interface is not zero, I show it to you also how we can find the correct interface as well, mainly in the Exynos processor or Samsung. Okay, we will try, guys. Great. Okay, you can look at here, guys. It's starting the DAC sims. This is already good. Okay, this is already running. Not it seems, but this is already running well. Now, I'm going to start, open this, and then I'm going to running this loopback. Okay, now I'm going to make a call to my number. Okay, I will just pick up the phone. Testing 1 2 3 1 2 3, testing. Okay, great. At least I just want to fetching the IP traffic in this case. Okay, guys, here we can see there are some UDP case in this case, right, guys? And it said here that for 7290 is IP. So what we're gonna do, we will decode this one because this is not yet decoded to IP. Decode this, and then I will just go to this one, and then go to this IP version 4. If later will be go to IP version 6, just you choose IP version 6, but now IP version 4. And then boom. Hey, please don't forget to subscribe, switch on the bell, and share this channel to others, so other people can get the same benefit from this video as well, or from this channel. Thank you so much. I will just filter the necessary one, USM tab, and then SIP SIP. Okay, guys, we can see here, right? For example, request invite. This is the phone call itself. Okay, this is the request invite. That means this is from my phone calling to the phone that we trace in this case. Okay, guys. And also we can see from here. Let's check in this case. Call from. We can also put this as a column. So this is, you can see this is the column full of the a number who called this one. Okay. Trying, ringing, and then after that status ringing, and then 200 okay invite, and then after that we can see from this one, okay, this is the call is ongoing, etc. And then after that this phone sending disconnect, this phone saying bye. Okay, so this is like this, guys. So we can see also from inside of this one, we can break down, this is the A party, and also there are some SIP or IMSIP also here, so I need to blur this one. Apologize, guys. Okay, and this is how we trace this one. Okay, now we will do again, guys. Okay, we will do again. So what we gonna do, I will just make a phone call. Okay, here, guys, this is my from my phone. Okay, I will just plug this. Okay, when I 200 status, okay, this is invite running to my bparty number in this case. Okay, you can see this is when my call, the one who do the tracing, it's tell what is the bparty is written here, guys. Okay, this is the MCC, MNC, etc. I think also we can put in this case, if you want, we can put like the bparty in this case. The bparty here. Let's make this as a column. SIP to address, okay? So this is clear, right? This is from blah blah blah, this is the phone call, etc. Trying. So we can see from this one, if you want to filter the SIP only, just simply do like this. So this is the SIP only, okay? But I prefer do like this. So at least you can learn usually from the invite what is will be the first GSM or RRC protocol that being sent. For example, after ringing, there's activate dedicated bearer contact request, etc. Okay, this is still ongoing. Okay, now I'm going to disconnect, okay? The one who will be disconnect is my phone now. Or I will just disconnect from this one. Okay, sending by. You can see my phone, this one requested by, status 200 by, okay in this case. Okay, that mean the connection, this connection is done. And then you can see the activate EPS bearer. So at least the goal of this why I filter GSM tab and SIP in this case, you can see, for example, what is the associated RRC that being sent or being sent among of those, between of those protocol SIP before when they try to make a call.
Also from the SIP transaction itself, if you can see from this one, there are, for example, there are some features. For example, this one, this is the features, and we can check from the feature itself. Let's see, I will just expand all everything from here. Like from the feature itself, you can see, for example, this one, single radio voice call continuity. This means if there is a capability that to make the continuity call, if this is jammed to the 2G or 3G or the legacy networks, the call still be able to be ongoing, or maybe the CS fallback will be kicked off in this case.
And that's not all.
Hello guys, if you feel you get some benefit from this video, I don't mind if you want to treat me coffee, a cup, 2 cups, 3 cups, 10 cups, 100 cups. I'm so happy if you want to treat me the coffee to me. I will give the Buy Me Coffee link in the descriptions of this video, or maybe you can follow this QR, this one, or this one. You just need to scan this QR and will lead you to the link of the Buy Me Coffee. Thank you so much, guys.
For example, you can see also this is, there is a RTP, RTP protocol. So for example, this is the RTP. I will just look at this one. For example, SIP, let's say, to see the flow of the RTP itself. So you can see this is, there are some RTP as well, right? After invite, connected, and there is some RTP protocol. And this RTP protocol is telling us this is actually, where is it? RTP. And this is RTP protocol, and tell this, okay, I'm using the codec adaptive multirate, IMR in this case. I think this is white, I think this is using the narrow band because it's using the maximum of IMR 12.2 kilobit. Well, there are so many, right? There's our PCMA, G2, G729, etc. And then from this RTP also beside me, look at the adaptive multirate with this single frame in this case. We can see also there are some interesting things in this case. Let's say for example, okay, this one. This is the codec for the, for example, if the voice, there is a blank voice in this case, the RTP still keep flowing with telling that, okay, this is his comfort noise form frame in this case. And of course, you can see as well, in this case, this one, this is, for example, this is the single frame in this case, okay? And also there is something also that we can say, this is a multi-frame like this. So example like this, so there are so many, beside the single frame, also there is a multi-frame. And guys, if we do like this, let's check with this one. I will just close this. I don't want to filter. Let's say using the RTP, RTP streams. Okay, this one go to this one, this one go to this one. If we do this, select this and select this, usually we can play some stream. But oops, somehow it's disconnected, guys. I'm wondering why this is disconnected when I want to play the stream. Maybe this is the from the S-Catalyst itself is not really pull all the frame. And for example, I like this one. This is the example if I want to play the codec itself. So example this one, this and this one, okay. So I can running the codec. Okay, this is for example from this pickup file. You can get this pickup file from this website, I think, guys. Where is it? This one. You just need to download this, and you can play that RTP stream in this case.
Okay, guys, I think that's very clear, and hopefully this is very useful for you. And I really happy to share this video. Hopefully this is useful. For example, if you do some research or any telecommunications protocol research and you want to learn some protocol, feel free to use this one. Okay guys, as I always say in my other previous video, keep learning and stay hard.